I am so excited for season two of Quantum Leap. Season one was amazing, and I cannot wait to share what we have in store. In season one, Dr. Benjamin Song gets lost in time. We don't know how, we don't know why, we just know that he got into the quantum accelerator. I, as his best friend and as the person who runs Ziggy, the AI that that determines what's going on in the leaps, am very distraught and very confused and disoriented and just really trying to figure out what's going on. So season one is it's a bit of a half mystery, half action adventure within the leaps. You know, Ben leaps into so many different individuals and gets to solve a problem within their lives so that he can get to the next leap. Get to see him travel through a lot of different really awesome time periods and characters as we try to figure out where he's headed and why he's headed there. And eventually it all comes out that I ruined everything somehow. It was all my fault. I in the future, set this whole thing in motion by leaping backwards to tell Ben that he needed a leap in order to save Addison. So it's I'm already lost just talking about it. But we figured it out, and it's all good. Ian had a really fun and interesting character development throughout the first season, because as the person who is in charge of Ziggy, as the person who's put so much of themselves into bringing this machine back online, a lot of Ian's identity and a lot of Ian's value as a contributor to this team is dependent on that machine working. And most of season one, that machine is not working properly. And we also realize that, you know, Ziggy may or may not be not a villain, because they're not malevolent in any way, but is a lot of the reason why we are in the predicament that we are in. So when they take Ziggy offline, so much of who Ian is built into their ability to show that, I can contribute something to this program because of this AI that is no longer working. So you kind of get to watch them go from being very confident and very sure of themselves to every week struggling to parse together why it is that they can't figure out how to solve this. And it's always really fun, I think, to watch intelligent people function, especially people who think differently, people who work primarily in the digital, computer space. They're quirky and they're geeky, and Ian is all of those things. And so it was really fun to watch them unravel as the season went on. But so when we leave them, they've kind of been through the ringer. You know, they have spent a very long time trying to bring their best friend into the present. And we discover throughout that season that a lot of it is their fault to begin with, that future Ian set this whole thing in motion by leaping back and telling Ben to get into the quantum accelerator when Ben did. And that has obviously weighed very heavily on me, on my character, because it's all my fault. We kind of don't really get to this kumbaya moment or this clean wrap up at the end for Ian's character. It's hard to talk about season two because I feel like the entire season is a spoiler in and of itself. What I can say is that the show is getting bigger, that the structure of it is changing in a way that's going to allow audiences to get to know the core cast a lot better. I think the first season we were really focusing on unraveling this grand, plot twisty mystery that the character moments kind of had to come in very quickly, in and out. And with season two, there are some changes at headquarters, there are some changes to the structure and the power dynamics of the characters that allow us to actually spend more time with each individual as the episodes progress. So I think that if you're a fan of magic, or you're a fan of Addison, or a fan of Ian, or Jen, you are going to learn a lot about these people that you may or may not have wanted to know in a way that I think is going to really excite audiences and viewers. No, season two has been, it's been a lot of fun to film. We quite literally did not have a break, that is for real. And so it's felt like we've been doing the show for a very long time, because we have. I was like, it feels like we've been doing this for a year, but it's because we've been doing this for a year. So it's cool because we've had a lot of time to actually sit with these characters and become a unit, become a familial, you know, unit with our crew, with our producers, with our writers. And there is something to be said about continuing the momentum of the story and not really taking, you know, like the summer to figure things out. Like, we went straight in. So there are a lot of shenanigans that are happening, because I think people have gotten way too comfortable in the best way, but also like pranks are abounding.